All right. First and foremost, I want to start off by saying Brakathia Hawa, Brakathia Hawa Shai, Brakathia Hawa, Brakathia Hawa Shai, Brakathia Hawa, Brakathia Hawa Shai, Kol Hala, Yahawa, Ba'ashem, Yahawa Shai, Ba'ashem, Raka, Kwadash. Double honors to the apostles of GMS who rule well and who taught me this truth. And shalom to you, sincere Akiyam, out there listening, learning, and pushing this truth. And shalom to the few sincere Akwath out there listening and learning as well. With that being said, I'm going to jump straight into this video. I don't want to rot this out. It'll be edifying. As usual, I'm going to go in the Raka Kwadash. It's going to be real quick. Real quick. As you can see, it's a video off of NBC News. It's a real short video, and it's entitled Texas Passes Bill Allowing People to Carry Handguns Without License. All right? Again, Texas passes bill allowing people to carry handguns without license. And before I play the video, I'm going to close out with the video. But it's not going to be long. Like I said, this is 2 Ezra 15. Read the whole chapter. Okay, read the whole chapter. Read 2 Ezra 16. As we always say, we're definitely in these times. Okay, we're in the times of the end. All right. And you got to walk circumspect. You know, try to stay in the spirit as best as possible, okay? Watch, stay on watch, you know? Don't be settled on your lees, you know? Occupy till the Lord comes, okay? So that way that day doesn't overtake you as a thief, okay? Because you best believe we are in them times, man, okay? All doors are, Slocky, the doors of mercy are drastically closing. All hell is going to break loose when you least expect it. All right, we're at the door of Jacob's trouble. All right, you know. This is like again, 2 Ezra 15, and I'll start at 10. The main point is going to be in verse 15, okay? But 2 Ezra 15, verse 10, behold, my people, who's the Lord's people? Israel, Yasharala, you tribes, okay? You so-called Negroes, West Indians, Haitians, Latinos, Hispanics, North American Seminole Indians. All right, and the Israelites, okay, that are scattered amongst the heathen nations, okay, who may look like the heathen nations, but their seed, okay, because the man carries the seed, okay, their lineage according to their father through the patriarch goes back to one of the 12 patriarchs of Israel, okay, Israelite foreigners, if you may have it, all right, you are the Lord's chosen people, no other nation, okay, all right, the curse is for us, no other nation, all right, you know. So it says, behold, my people is led as a flock to the slaughter, and I will not suffer them now to dwell in the land of Egypt. And we know that's talking about America, spiritually Sodom and Egypt, Babylon the Great. Okay? But I will bring them with a mighty hand and a stretched out arm with slack it. Behold, my people is led as a flock to the slaughter. I will not suffer them now to dwell in the land of Egypt. But I will bring them with a mighty hand and a stretched out arm and smite Egypt with plagues as before. Okay? Because this is not talking about ancient Egypt. This is talking about modern day Egypt, which is spiritually America. You know, Egypt represents bondage, which is right here in America, Babylon the Great. Okay? Spiritually Sodom and Egypt. But I will bring them with a mighty, and we're in these times, man. All right? You know? But I will bring the second Exodus, if you may have it. But I will bring them with a mighty hand and a stretched out arm and smite Egypt with plagues as before and will destroy all the land thereof. Okay? And that's a future prophecy. America's going to be utterly destroyed. Okay? Ophir, as the elders brought out, it's going to be reduced to ashes. Okay? Utterly destroyed. It says, Egypt shall mourn in the foundation of it. Hey, and what's going to do that? The ultimate plague, the nukes. Thermonuclear destruction. It says, Egypt shall mourn, and the foundation of it shall be smitten with the plague and the punishment that Yahweh shall bring upon it. Hey, yeah, the ultimate plague is going to be them nukes, man. You know? It says, They that till the ground shall mourn, for their seed shall fail through the blasting and hail, and with a fearful constellation. Woe, meaning destruction, woe to the world and them that dwell therein. For the sword and their destruction draweth nigh. And that's what we keep telling you. All right? Jacob's trouble is drawing nigh. All right? You see? Repent. The doors of mercy are drastically closing. For the sword, and the sword is a killing instrument. The modern day sword is the gun. Okay? For the sword and the and their destruction draweth nigh. And one people shall stand up. And that's what it says in Matthew 24. Okay? That's how we know we're at the time to the end. It says, for the sword and their destruction draweth nigh, and one people shall stand up and fight against another, and swords in their hands. The scriptures tell you that for the lack of bread, the love of many shall wax cold. Okay? It says, for there shall be sedition among men, and invading one another. It says, they shall not regard their kings nor princes, and the course of their actions shall stand in their power. A man shall desire to go into a city and shall not be able, for because of their pride the city shall be troubled. The houses shall be destroyed and men shall be afraid. A man shall have no pity upon his neighbor, but shall destroy their houses with the sword. The modern day sword is the gun, okay? And spoil their goods because of the lack of bread and for great tribulation. The time of Jacob's trouble, okay? You see, we're in these times. All right, and you can see, hey, Texas is turning back to the old Wild Wild West. Okay, you see. So anyway, like I always say, keep pushing. We're close. Shalom. Wa abad babal. I don't want to rot this out. This was edifying.
Tonight in Texas, getting hands on a handgun about to become even easier. Lawmakers in Austin passing House Bill 1927, allowing anyone 21 and up who is legally allowed to buy a handgun. No license needed.
Anything that allows our law-abiding citizens to protect themselves and their family is a good thing.
Nationwide, similar handgun measures already exist in 20 states. In Texas, the law eliminates not only the license, but also the written test, training, and state background checks.
Does this make...
I'll let you hear that again. It's the Wild Wild West. Turning it into the Wild Wild West out there, man. Matter of fact, from the top. Salakia. We in them times, man. Repent.
Tonight in Texas, getting hands on a handgun about to become even easier. Lawmakers in Austin passing House Bill 1927, allowing anyone 21 and up who is legally allowed to buy a handgun. No license needed.
Anything that allows our law-abiding citizens to protect themselves and their family is a good thing.
Nationwide, similar handgun measures already exist in 20 states. In Texas, the law eliminates not only the license, but also the written test, training, and state background checks.
Does this make your job harder?
I think it does.
Mike Mata is president of the Dallas Police Association.
Supporters would say more good guys with guns makes your job even easier.
Well, my answer to that is, how do I know you're a good guy? Well, you might go to a scene and now you have 3, 4, 5 people that are openly carrying a firearm.
The bill also turning attention to recent mass shootings. Just last month, a gunman opened fire in Bryan, Texas, using a handgun to kill one coworker and wound 5 others.
And despite the bill's popularity at gun ranges like this one, statewide polls still have 58% of Texans opposed. Governor Greg Abbott says he'll sign the bill as soon as it hits his desk.
Thanks for watching.